Joshua, Yehoshua, chapter 24. Yehoshua gathered all the tribes of Israel to Shechem. He summoned the leaders, heads, judges, and officials of Israel, and they presented themselves before God. Yehoshua said to all the people, "This is what Adonai, the God of Israel, says. In iniquity your ancestors lived on the other side of the Euphrates River, Terach, the father of Abraham, and Nahor, and they served other gods. I took your ancestor Abraham from beyond the river, led him through all the land of Canaan, increased his descendants, and gave him Yitzchak. I gave to Yitzchak Yaakov and Esau. To Esau I gave Mount Seir as his possession. But Yaakov and his children went down into Egypt. I sent Moshe and Aaron. I inflicted plagues on Egypt in accordance with what I did among them. And afterwards I brought you out. Yes, I brought your fathers out of Egypt. You arrived at the sea, and the Egyptians were pursuing your ancestors with chariots and horsemen to the Sea of Suf. But when they cried out to Adonai, he put darkness between you and the Egyptians, overwhelmed them with the sea, and drowned them. Your eyes saw what I did in Egypt, and then you lived in the desert for a long time. I brought you into the land of the Amorite, living beyond the Jordan. They fought against you, but I handed them over to you. You took possession of their land, and I destroyed them ahead of you. Then Balak, the son of Zippor, king of Moab, rose up and fought against Israel. He sent and summoned Balaam, the son of Beor, to put a curse on you. But I refused to listen to Balaam, and he actually blessed you. In this way, I rescued you from him. Next, you crossed the Jordan and came to Jericho. The men of Jericho fought against you, the Amorite, Perizzi, Kenani, Hittai, Girgashi, Hivai, and Yebusi, and I handed them over to you. I sent the hornet ahead of you, driving them out from ahead of you, the two kings of the Amorite. It wasn't by your sword or your bow. Then I gave you a land where you had not worked, and cities you had not built, and you lived there. You eat fruit from vineyards and olive groves, which you did not plant. Therefore, fear Adonai and serve him truly and sincerely. Put away the gods of your ancestors, serve beyond the Euphrates River and in Egypt, and serve Adonai. If it seems bad to you to serve Adonai, then choose today whom you are going to serve. Will it be the gods your ancestors served by on the river, or the gods of the Amorite, in whose land you are living? As for me and my household, we will serve Adonai." The people answered, "Far be it from us that we would abandon Adonai to serve other gods, because it is Adonai, our God, who brought us and our fathers up out of the land of Egypt from a life of slavery, and did those great signs before our eyes, and preserved us all along the way we traveled, and among all the peoples we passed through. And it was Adonai who drove out from ahead of us all the peoples, the Amorite living in the land. Therefore, we too will serve Adonai, for he is our God." Yehoshua said to the people, "You can't serve Adonai because he is a holy God, a jealous God, and he will not forgive your crimes and sins. If you abandon Adonai and serve foreign gods, he will turn, doing you harm and destroying you after he has done you good." But the people said to Yehoshua, "No, but we will serve Adonai." Yehoshua said to the people, "You are witnesses against yourselves that you have chosen Adonai to serve him." They answered, "We are witnesses." Now Yehoshua urged, "But put away the foreign gods you have among you and turn your hearts to Adonai, the God of Israel." The people answered Yehoshua, "We will serve Adonai our God. We will pay attention to what he says." So Yehoshua made a covenant with the people that day, laying down for them laws and rulings there in Shechem. Yehoshua wrote these words in the book of the Torah of God. Then he took a big stone and set it up there under the oak next to the sanctuary of Adonai. Yehoshua said to all the people, "See, this stone will be a witness against us, because it has heard all the words of Adonai which he has said to us. Therefore, it will be a witness against you in case you deny your God." Then Yehoshua sent the people away, every man to his inheritance. After this, Yehoshua the son of Nun, the servant of Adonai, died. He was 110 years old. They buried him on his property in Timnat Serach, which is in the hills of Ephraim, north of Mount Gaash. Israel served Adonai throughout Yehoshua's lifetime and throughout the lifetimes of the leaders who outlived Yehoshua and had known all the deeds that Adonai had done on behalf of Israel. The bones of Yosef, which the people of Israel had brought up from Egypt, they buried in Shechem, and the parcel of ground which Yaakov had brought from the sons of Hamor and the father of Shechem for 100 pieces of silver, and they became a possession of the descendants of Yosef. Finally, Eleazar, the son of Aaron, died, and they buried him on the hill belonging to Pinchas, his son, which had been given to him in the hills of Ephraim,